You know, one of the neat things about this position is not only do you become a chaplain to the athlete, but you actually become a chaplain to the athlete's family. You get a chance to build relationships and trust.
My mom has been praying for me since I started playing sports. You know, not only in football, but every baseball game, basketball game, she would just pray. My mom, she's a God-fearing woman. I was 14 years old and my mom was diagnosed with breast cancer. And I told myself that I didn't want to play sports anymore because, you know, I felt that I was going through breast cancer while she was going through it also. So I felt that my job was to be her protector. She told me, you know, I'm going to be okay. You know, don't stop playing sports. Don't stop doing what you love to do. And she just told me to just use that gift, you know, use it through football. Let football be an outlet for not only me, but for our entire family.
I remember with Teddy Bridgewater. Teddy's mom was the Christian backbone of that family, and her being in Miami and Teddy being in Louisville, there's a long distance between the two.
Chris, he's been a great resource to me. Being that I'm hundreds of miles away from home in Miami, and my mom couldn't just be there physically, but she was there spiritually. Chris came into my life my freshman year when things weren't going so well. And it was a point I wasn't starting during fall camp. And I would walk around the facility with a hooded jacket on, wouldn't talk to anyone. And I just talked to one person, that was Chris. And I told Chris, I'm ready to go home. You know, I'm not starting. I don't even want to play football anymore. You know, I just want to go back home. And he told me, you know, he prayed for me. We talked about it and everything.
So I remember getting many calls from Rose Murphy. And one in particular, she asked me, she said, look, I've always prayed for Teddy every game, and I'm not going to be able to be at this game. Would you mind doing me a favor? And I said, absolutely, I'd love to do it. She said, would you tell Teddy to come down and meet you in the lobby and him sit in a chair and say that you're going to pray over him? And what I do basically is I just touch Teddy's head and I pray that he would have the mind of Christ, that he would be a leader of Jesus. Will you touch his hands and say, will you use his hands to bring glory to your name? Will you touch his knees and pray over his knees and say, will you keep his knees safe only that he can use his athletic ability as a platform to share Jesus? Could you touch his feet and pray that everywhere he goes, will he be a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ? And I said, yes, ma'am, I will do that. And sure enough, I asked Teddy if he would come down. And as he came down, I just sat a chair, and Teddy knew exactly what to do. He sat down in the chair because he had done it many times. He sat down in the chair, he bowed his head, he held out his hands, and I listened to the request. I just prayed for him. And it was a turning moment in my life because now I realized that these athletes come from Christian homes. And what these Christian families want is they just want these principles and these Christian guidelines to be continued when they go to college.
And I'm thankful that Chris did come into my life at that point because, you know, at that point I was really ready to just go home. But he told me that, you know, things may not go the way you want them to now, but when God shows up, he's going to show out. You know, blessings are delayed but never denied. So at that time, it was pretty much a minor setback for a major comeback. And Chris, he played a huge role in that.